I'm Tamara Payne, and I'll be reading from The Dead Are Arising. I am a co-author, written with my father, Les Payne. I'll be reading from the opening of the book. The metallic clicking of hoofbeats on the gravel road draw five-year-old Wilfred to the small pane window. His mother, wiping her hands, hurried to the front door as a group of horsemen with flickering torches rode up to the wood frame home on the outskirts of Omaha, Nebraska. Little, yelled one of the half dozen men. Louise Little said that her husband was not at home, and with the tree leaves rustling in the evening breeze, the horsemen steadied their mounts in the front yard and declared that they were the knights of the Ku Klux Klan. Get that nigger out here now, one of the strangers shouted. Haltingly, the young housewife said that her family didn't cause trouble or bother neighbors, that they minded their own business. Seen against the flickering kerosene light, Mrs. Little stood taller than the average man of her day, at more than 5'8". She was pregnant. She was big, Wilfred said. She was expecting at any time, carrying a boy they would name Malcolm, who would be born on May 19, 1925. Y'all better get on out of town, said the man in front, exclaiming that they don't tolerate troublemakers, bristling before the young family. The Klansmen clutched their shotguns and made all kinds of threats, aimed chiefly at the absent man of the house. The unfolding drama puzzled the eldest child of the household. My mother kept arguing, Wilfred said. The Klan leader got mad. He took the butt of his rifle and knocked the front window out. Baby brother Filbert started crying in a back room, and three-year-old Hilda tugged at her mother's house dress. If fear of the gunman gripped Mrs. Little, her children detected no sign in her tone and body language. The children, in fact, drew lasting strength from her manner, in which their mother stood her ground before the bullying white strangers on horseback. However, Wilfred would conclude later that it was helped greatly that his father was indeed not at home. Thank you.